Hey everyone, welcome back to the Quad Spot, your spot for the next generation of YouTube. I'm Randy.
I'm Dave.
I'm Jay.
I'm Steve.
And I'm Toden.
And we're back with Jason Ergo. I apologize for the first half calling you Jason Ergo. This is my first time meeting you doing this interview, so let's talk more about Social Blade.
Sure. What do you want to know?
What gave you the idea to even open a website like Social Blade?
Yeah, good question. It's actually had a long history before YouTube really came into the mix. Originally, it started out sort of giving statistics on another website, dig.com, which used to be, you know, these days Reddit's sort of the big one, but it used to be the big site to go to get all sorts of news and, you know, voted up and that type of a thing. But anyway, I created it originally there to sort of track people's submissions on that site and see, you know, how many digs it took for a story to get to the front page, as well as a whole bunch of other statistics, and also give top lists of the people that have been most successful over there. When I created it, though, I originally did plan on adding other sites. It just took a couple of years before I decided to put the YouTube stats site there. And specifically, why did I, you know, decide one day to put that up? There's another stats site that's still around, but it decided one day to close down permanently, put up a message saying, we're, you know, too much drama, I think it said, we're shutting down for good. And I had been using that site to track my YouTube stats, and I just was like, you know what? That sucks. I can create this myself, though, and I did over the weekend, and basically had all the functionality of that. It looked really, really bad, but it was up and running, and yeah, ever since then, I've just been improving on it, and it's been growing like mad.
Did you hear that, Mark Zuckerberg? A weekend.
Yes.
Well, no, even, well, depending on how much of you believe in the movie, but, you know, he was able to do a lot really quickly, too. I think he created his first site again based on the movie in, like, a night while he was drunk. So,
what's that? We use a thing called Google Plus here. I don't know what yes. This other thing you speak of is.
Mark,
is it like, MySpace or LiveJournal?
So Social Blade, do you get a lot of drama with Social Blade? Do you get a lot of people upset with what your stats show?
I have actually gotten a number of comments. I would say not nearly as many compared to how many people use the site, but I do every now and then get people complaining like, hey, why are you showing my stats, or blah, 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 you know, related to that. And I basically just go and tell them, listen, these are publicly available stats. YouTube, first off, shows them on their site itself, and then has this API that they allow anyone to sort of build off of. And, you know, it's all public information, basically. I'm not showing anything that's private. There's estimated earnings you can see on there to sort of show how much channels are making. But that there is just math. It's basically taking, you know, how many views you're getting and multiplying by what sort of the general level is for how much each view costs, you know, each view pays. And with that, it can, you know, estimate how much channels make. So, yeah, no, I've definitely gotten people complaining, but
it's, all this talk about math is making my head hurt.
Sorry.
toting a head like that should hurt.
Well, sorry, I don't have all this.
You don't have all this. Remember,
I have to have something to fall back on.
Literally, falling back on. But anyhow, one of the questions I had was, you know, your views sometimes, my view count on Social Blade is more accurate sometimes than my YouTube view count. How is that sometimes? Because I'll notice that YouTube, I can't get it'll won't show the right number, but on Social Blade it will.
Well, even on Social Blade, the view count, sometimes you might see zero views for a day, even though you're really getting views. That really all comes down to two things. YouTube, if you ever notice when you put up a video, it usually stops about 300 views. YouTube basically does view auditing once they get there, and that is a long process that they go through and make sure you've watched, you know, a certain amount of the video, you're not a bot, and it's an actual real view. And then they update it every so often after that. It might be a few hours, it might take even up to a day or two. And as a result, Social Blade also actually, you know, since we're just querying YouTube asking how many views has this channel had, it sometimes doesn't have the updated number yet. So even Social Blade might not have 100% the right number. However, it will get it eventually. You know, it might take a day or two for the views to show up. It's, you know, sometimes.
Now I have a question for you, Jason.
Sure.
You said that there was over 160,000 YouTube channels that you're tracking?
Yes, at the moment, I think, hold on, I'll get you the number, but I believe, yeah, 167,622 channels I'm tracking daily, and I think about 12,000 or so of those get updated every hour.
Awesome. Very awesome, because that puts me in the top quarter.
So, how did you come, like, besides just coming up with it, did you, like, you obviously you're a computer programmer.
Yeah.
So, you know, how long have you been studying computers and doing stuff like this before Social Blade came out? You
warning, said
you
did it for nerd alert, site. Warning, nerd alert, tech talk.
Yeah, no, I've actually been probably programming since I was, I don't know, around like seventh grade or so. I had a really old computer back then, but yeah, I've been just doing things on my own for quite a while. I went to school, I got a computer science degree from school also, so been trained in that also, if you will. But yeah, so many years. I'm 31 now, so do the math. However old I was in seventh grade.
My first computer I had to program in order to play it.
Yeah.
So how would you expect people, like, when they go to Social Blade, what would be useful in terms of, other than like the numbers, how would you find that the users would find the information that they get there useful? You know what I mean?
Well, there's just based off, I guess, comments that I've gotten from other people, and a lot of people have made videos about the site, and I go and watch those whenever I can find them and see what they're talking about. And sort of some of the things that I found people really like and find useful are the similarly ranked channels feature that's on there that'll sort of go and show, okay, you have 3,000 subscribers. Who else has about that many? And same with views. And I have something called an SB rank on there. So it's different ways you can rank yourself. And you can go out and find, you know, who is also ranked around there, and go and contact those channels and maybe do collabs or, you know, do box for box if you're into that. And those type of things, you know, help grow both you and the other person as well. And that people have found really useful, I guess.
So when you say similar ranked, are you talking about like similar like viewers or like, you know?
Not demographics, but okay. Again, if your channel has 3,000 subscribers or 300 subscribers, you can go and see what other channels also have about that number. Because what YouTube recommends always is to, you know, if you want to grow your channel, you want to not necessarily reach out to someone that has, you know, a million subscribers or something like that, because it's more likely than not they're not going to be able to really, you know, promote your channel or something like that. They wouldn't do that. But if you reach out to someone that has the same amount as you, you're probably at the same level on YouTube at that point. And yeah, they'll work with you most likely.
That's great advice.
That makes really sense.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, Jack Vale and I worked together tonight, and we're similarly ranked. He's somewhere around a quarter of a million subscribers, and I'm right around a quarter of 10,000 subscribers. So, yeah.
And I'm right around a quarter, period. Just
hey, you know what? My channel's going copper anytime now, so copper. I'm doing all right.
No, I really probably once a week I head over to Social Blade and check my stats, and then I check the you know the top five YouTubers stats to, you know, just to get me back into that depressed state. And no, it's a great site, and it's not limited solely to YouTube either, is it?
Now, do you think
you can get stats from other social media sites as well?
Like I said, Dig was the other one that's on there that it originally started with.
Isn't there also like a Facebook tool or something like that too?
No, there's no Facebook tool right now. It's just Dig and YouTube.
Okay.
Now, do you think Social Blade may be intimidating to some of the newer YouTubers when they go check other people's stats?
Well, I guess it depends how you're using it there. If you go and you look specifically just at the top people on there, I guess it could be pretty intimidating. But you can go and you can look up anyone's stats. That's the great thing about it there. Again, anyone that has at least 5 subscribers can be added into there.
Someday, and- Jay. Someday.
There's a goal.
But, I mean, you can, again, when you're comparing yourself there, you see all these other channels that also have about the same as you.
Okay. I'm going to try to sum some of this up. Okay. So part of the goals is to not only see where you're at, but see where other people similar to you are at. Maybe set goals, figure out who you want to collaborate with that's around the same level. Am I missing anything else? I know I am.
just one of the things, I guess, also is it does give actual goals for subscribers. So, for example, it looks like the Quad Spot's at 95 subscribers right now. And it gives you a goal of 100, for example, and it says, based on how many you're gaining right now, you should hit 100 by February 11th.
We hit it today, unless we lost a few, because I know we
were going to take care of it. No, okay, so that's a little different there. There's, at the moment, discrepancy between YouTube and basically anything other than YouTube. They did a big removal of dead accounts back on January 12th, but they haven't yet updated YouTube itself with those numbers. They're giving the numbers out via the API, but you don't actually have that many. So, yeah, on YouTube right now, it looks like you have 101, but you really only have 95.
Ouch! Right. Oh, we were all going to celebrate too.
You bring out the champagne
at the end of the show.
February 9th, they just published today that they're going to be doing the update for real itself.
Okay, because this channel's only been around for, 2, maybe 3 months, so what qualifies as a dead account? How do we get a dead account to subscribe to us?
A dead account in the sense that someone subscribed and then either had a copyright violation, their account that, or they decided to close their account. It's not just someone that stopped watching video.
I know who I'm looking at, but I'm not going to say who it is.
Now, who is it that Jason likes to, keep up with on his site? When you log on in the morning, I know there's probably a couple people that you want to see their channels and keep up with them. So who does Jason like to stalk on a Social Blade?
To be honest, I really am mostly just using it to look at my own stats on there, and then I just have other people there that I look at just to make sure the site's functioning. But to be quite honest, I pretty much just look at my own stats. I have a bunch of channels, but that's what I'm using it for. And I guess compare my ranks and make sure that it's going up or not going down too far.
What's some of your favorite YouTube channels? Lower end, preferably, like your Dirty Little Secrets.
That's a tough question. Most of the videos, I guess, I watch, we talked about on the previous segment, are YouTube Orbiters. So I watch a lot of YouTube Orbit videos. For people that might have, you said lower end. I actually did a video about this a while ago. I forget who I put on there. But I did rank like top five people that had less than 500. I can't remember who I named at that point. But I'm talking all around this here. I'd say at the moment, just go to one of my other channels. Again, the vloggers, Toden K. He's funny. I need to say that. But anyone that does the YouTube Orbit, go watch their videos. YouTube.
All right.
YT Orbit. You'll find everyone on there.
Ladies and gentlemen, Jason Ergo, Thank you so much for coming and being on the show with us. We truly do appreciate what you do with Social Blade and the fact that you took the time out of your day to come and talk with us.
You're very welcome. So
thank you very much.
Thank you. Yeah,
thanks.
Thank you so much, Jason.
You can check out Jason Ergo's channel down in the description box, and you can also check out the Quad Spots previous episode with Jason Ergo in the description. And we will see you guys on, is it Wednesday?
Yes, it is.
Wednesday.
All right. Be sure to check out
all of our social media websites. I'll take it off your hands. All the social media websites, be it Twitter. You can follow us on Twitter and be sure to spread the word about all of our stuff there. Retweet our stuff and spread the word. Circle us on Google, you know, and send us an email. Quadspot@email.com. I believe it's quadspot@gmail.com. If you if you have comments too, yeah. But if you have anything you want to ask us, or if you have content suggestions, or if you want to be in the show, just send us an email through YouTube or any other site that you can get in contact with us, and we'll be happy to have you on.
And please subscribe, because Jason just told us we don't have the numbers we thought we did.
Yeah.
So please click the subscribe button and tell a friend, because, you know, I'm going to have to go cry now after the show.
It's right up there. It's going to cry all over this.
All right, everybody, you have a good day.
Yes, and thanks for watching.